Fowler, and I'm with the Atlanta Post. I'm here with Devon Franklin, the author of Produced by Faith. He's also the Vice President of Production at Columbia Pictures.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Thanks for having me.
So let's start out by talking about the book. What kind of inspired you to write it?
You know, over my time in being in Hollywood and also, you know, preaching, I get bombarded by people all the time. How do you make it? How do you find success? And truthfully, the thing I point them to is the Word and God and your faith. Your faith is your path to success. And I really wanted to put something in the world that would operate as a manual to help people see how they can navigate their life and their career using the principles of God's Word and also relying on their faith as a compass to get them where they want to go.
How did you decide that you wanted to pursue a career in the entertainment industry?
You know, it's a good question. Earlier in my life, I wanted to be a running back for the Dallas Cowboys. And my first scrimmage in high school football, I got hurt. And so I gave up those dreams, and it felt like God was leading me to Hollywood. And also at a young age, I remember my father passed away when I was 9. And that around that time, I didn't really have, you know, the option for therapy because my mom didn't have the money for that. And so movies, you know, was really therapy for me and going to church. And so, you know, I wanted to really figure out, how can I get behind the camera? How can I help create those images? How can I help make that feeling that you get when going to the theater? And so coming out of that, and once I knew that I wasn't going to play for the Cowboys, I was all, you know, set on getting into Hollywood.
So once you decided that, what was the first step that you took?
The first step that I took was in high school, I knew that getting into the business, I needed to find an internship and I needed to come to school in LA. So I ended up getting accepted to USC. And so that was like, you know, job number one, getting into Los Angeles, because you can't really do entertainment unless you're in LA. You know, I'm sorry to say that. I know a lot of people live in Atlanta and New York, and Atlanta is certainly coming up.
Yeah, it is.
But LA is still where Hollywood is, and certainly there's a lot more opportunity to make it in the business in LA. So I got to USC, and then my second order of business was to get an internship. And I was really, really blessed to get my first internship working for Benny Medina and James Lasseter at Handprint Entertainment, which was a management company for Will and Jada and Vivica at the time.
Nice.
And I got that my freshman year when I was 18 years old, and interned every single year while I was going to school. And so that gave me a really strong foundation that helped me get my foot in the door.
And when you say it helped you get your foot in the door, what was your next step after that?
Well, in you know, when you're trying to pursue the career of, like, you know, being a producer or being a studio executive, what you do is you start as an assistant. And the business is very much still an apprenticeship business where you advance by learning. And so my first job was to get an assistant gig. I was, you know, very fortunate that James Lasseter, who is Will Smith's business partner and also runs Overbrook Entertainment, that he gave me my first assistant job. So coming right out of USC, you know, I was a second assistant on his desk, and that gave me, you know, like my foot in the door. You know, I was answering phones, doing scheduling, getting coffee, doing, you know, copies. Anything that needed to be done to run the office is what my job responsibilities were. And I was there for about a year and a half, left Overbrook, and Tracy Edmonds gave me my first executive job. So I became an executive at her company and, you know, went from there to MGM. MGM was my first studio job. And about 6 years ago, MGM got sold to Columbia, to Sony Pictures, along with a bunch of other investors, and I was, you know, blessed to be able to make that transition. And so I've been at Columbia now for about 6 years.
Cool.
Yeah.
So would you say that being an assistant is the best way to get your foot in the door? I've heard that.
Yeah, I mean, here's the thing. People look down on, you know, being an assistant. It's like, oh, I don't want to get anyone's coffee, and oh, I don't want to, you know, make copies. But what we don't realize sometimes is, and I talk about this in the book, is that in order to get in production in our life, we have to go through development. And being an assistant is a critical part of development, because as much as we want to think we know, we don't really know until we're in it and we can do it and we can figure it out for ourselves.
Yeah.
And being an assistant is critical, and it's painstaking though. I mean, it is. I mean, trust me, you know, I mean, I've had my, you know, my nightmares as an assistant and my long nights of the soul where I question, why am I here and what am I doing? But I wouldn't have exchanged those days for anything.
What do you do day to day as an exec?
Every day is different.
Okay.
But primarily my job as vice president of production for Columbia Pictures is to find movies. So what I do, people send me scripts all the time. They send me books. They send me graphic novels. They send me, you know, pitches. You know, we just saw this piece online. So my goal is to identify great material, buy that material, and develop that material to the point where it's ready to go into production.
What movie have you put out that you feel like has been the most special for you?
Oh, man, that's a hard, hard question. I would say the three movies. Sorry, I got to choose three. Pursuit of Happiness, which I worked on, that I'm very, very proud of having the opportunity to even be involved in that. Karate Kid was a great experience for me. And Jumping the Broom. These three films, I feel, were bigger than just movies. And that the people that they touched in terms of Pursuit of Happiness and Karate Kid, amazing. And I'm hoping and praying and believing that Jumping the Broom will also have a similar impact. Because I think it will inspire people, it will make them laugh, it'll make them think. And overall, it's just good entertainment.
What message do you hope that people take from your book?
The message I hope that people take from my book is you do not have to compromise your faith to find success. And I think there is this idea that in order to have the highest level of success, at some point you have to compromise what you believe. And I want people to take away from this message in the book that that's not true. Mm-hmm. You can hold on to who you are and who God has made you to be, and that will be more than enough to get you where you want to go. We all are so focused, though, on, oh, I want to get in production, and oh, I want this position, and oh, I want this promotion, that we lose sight on God's not concerned about where we get per se. He's more concerned about who we are. And I want people to get from this book that we need to work on us, work on our character, work on what we want and why we want it. And once we get us right, where we go, that'll happen.
I think that's a really powerful message that is lacking in Hollywood. I think a lot of people can get sucked in and, kind of distracted. So I think that's a really powerful message. Now, your book hits shelves on May 3rd.
May 3rd. Yeah, book hits shelves Tuesday, May 3rd, and the movie comes out Friday, May 6th.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, so we're just, trying to do it all.
Well, good luck with that. I think it's a very powerful message. Mm-hmm. So thank you so much for stopping by and sharing that with us.
Thank you for
really
letting
appreciate
me.
It.
I appreciate it, too.
And don't forget to check out the Atlanta Post for the full interview, atlantapost.com. And also grab the book. It hits shelves May 3rd. And Jumping the Broom starts May 6th. So definitely go check that out.